Hello everybody, welcome to my channel. It's Eva from Bohemian Crafting here again, and today I'm gonna show you how to wrap any kind of bottles or tube items, even food if you wanna give to somebody food in tube, an unexpected shape where we can struggle how to wrap it nicely and decoratively. So I'm gonna show you how to make beautiful wrapping using book pages and few things you may will find at home. To wrap the things like bottles like this or cans or even food, maybe cucumber or salami, to someone you wanna offer something to refresh, it can be much more easy than to wrap the bottles, which has a different shape, which has a bigger shape on the one end and very smaller shape on the another end. And even things like this can be wrapped into this cute wrapping, and it needs just few steps. First, what you would like to prepare for yourself, it's take book pages from some book you know you will don't read anymore, because it's maybe boring, or it maybe it's some encyclopedia which has totally wrong information. So choose the book you wanna use, rip the papers and glue them to big sheet. You wanna make a piece of paper where you can have your item you're gonna wrap in the middle, and on the sides you will have about 1.5 inch on each side, and when you will wrap it, you can wrap it all plus about 5 inches more the leg. So the big like this. Then next step you need to do is take some cardstock. Put your bottle on it, take a pencil, draw around, and cut two similar circles. Circles like this. Wrap them from one side to book pages as well. If you do have a bottle, sometimes those bottles can have a different shape. They can be very tight here, then big bottle here, and then to smaller one here again. So if you have the biggest size somewhere in the middle, you need to take that biggest size of your bottle, and sometimes it's very hard to to decide how big circle you're gonna need for those sides. So take the bottle, put the bottle on piece of paper with one side on the edge of that paper, choose the biggest size of the bottle and draw a mark. Then fold the edge of the paper to that mark on your paper here, and you need to draw this the half circle here. It can be difficult. You can take some help for that. So if you do have at home your own compass, use the compass, put one side of that compass here and draw that half of the circle. If you don't have compass and you are not sure that you will make the half circle right way or right side, took three pencils, wrap two together this way. Wrap the third one to put those together here and here, and you are creating your own compass. Then you need to measure this, the size where you have that folding. I'm gonna do it this way. Size of that folding, hold one pencil and draw your half. Then cut it, redraw it on the cardboard and cut two circles like this. Now we're gonna put the bottle in the middle of your paper. I've got here to help myself to good to make good measuring, I've got here just this wooden stick. I'm gonna place that wooden stick here on that side to the end of that bottle and have a look if this size it's similar on both sides. I'm gonna make a mark for myself and we will create those side decorative panels now. So make a mark or put some paper and, you know, make a strip you need to have on those sides. So I will need, this is the edge on both sides here. To creating those beautiful decorative edges here, you will need another book pages. And make it faster, take a book page, fold it on half and try to have piece which is in the size of your mark, like this. I'm using this wood stick because it's also great help to put all these together. Put a little bit of hot glue to your folded book page. Place there that wooden stick and start to wrap it. So when I do have a rolled piece like this, just letting it sit down on the table and spread it evenly-ish. Kind of like this. I'm gonna put hot glue in the middle. And take my roll and place it there, just like that. That's the start. And then I'm taking rest of these papers. Here I wanna spread it kind of better way. And then I'm taking those folded book pages. I'm always placing, a little bit of glue here on the end of one piece, placing there another piece, and I think here I cut it too big, so I'm gonna then cut it with my scissors. And then I'm just rolling that book page around, not too tight, and going behind that with my hot glue. Just secure it a little bit. It doesn't even have to be all the way. Just here and there. Make sure you cut right sizes of papers. Here I cut too big, so I'm gonna cut it right now because it will be really big. So just this way, I'm securing those book pages. I'm gonna take my scissors, cut this now. And I think I will need to put there a little bit more of hot glue. And because I cut this one too big, and I'm not too much scared of if is it straight or not, because, you know, it's supposed to be vintage. So any kind of not right edges will be good. So I'm gonna cut this a little bit down and continue. Again, I'm gonna put a little bit of hot glue here on that last piece. Place there my folded book page. And then I'm gonna fold that book page, not too tight, around. And here and there, secure it with hot glue. That shape. And continue this way till the end. Once you have your rolling done, like this pretty much full. It's time to get it look vintage if you are going for that look. And because this is like vintage style of letter, I guess you will go for that look. So there is so many different options. You can use distress inks, which are brilliant, and just slide the distress ink on over the edges, and it will also a little bit fold your book pages, so it will gives you a little bit more of that ripped and distressed look. Or you can use some already made products like this amazing stains by Petit Pocket. It's made by Patricia Viramontes and it's really wonderful. Or super simple. Make very strong tea or coffee and use tea. And that's what I'm gonna use today. I'm gonna just dab the tea inside and let it dry. The tea will fold it my book pages. And the tea will also nicely color them to that aged look. And I'm gonna let it dry. I'm gonna make this way also my paper for wrapping and let it dry as well. And meanwhile, all these will get dry. We will create those buttons on the side. And there is so many wonderful options how you can make them. So I'm gonna show you a few of them. So while our papers and those side circles are drying, we're gonna create these side knobs. If you are a lucky person, maybe you have those doorknobs which are already in this shape. But if you are like me, you have to create them. These I have made from paper circles, which I punched from normal cardboard box. Then I glued four together and I have used wooden beads, which I tied with a wire. I just cut piece of wire. I hope I will find some tool. Bear with me. So I cut piece of wire. Put the wire through to that bead. Here I tied it together nicely. That the ends of wire. So tied it together. Wrap it here. And four circles glued together with glue. I'm just gonna quickly put there a little bit of glue. So four pieces together. And of course I have used smaller circles because that was small small bead. So I made a hole in the middle. Put through there those ends of wire. I think I need to make it bigger. Like this. Go there. I've been holding it here. Took a hot glue gun, put a little bit of hot glue here, and then just slide it down and let it dry. You can also use, if you don't want to use the paper, you can use buttons and do exactly same with a wire. Put that way. Put a little bit of glue here and drop it down and here wrap it together. So you can use the beads and buttons. You can sew it together. And for this big one, I have used these crystals from Chandelier. I just used this wire. Sorry for my camera. I just used this wire here and exactly same way I put it through and then put a little bit of hot glue here. But if you don't have any of this, maybe you do have walnuts like this. You can use the walnuts. And you can wire them to to those paper circles. Or like I will do today. So if I will use the wire, I will try to wrap that wire around the nuts. Tied it here nicely. Maybe put there a little bit of glue. And then same way, put it through. Put there a little bit of hot glue and just let it dry. But today I'm gonna use this one. I've got in my stuff these circles, wooden circles, wooden, I'm not sure what is it, rings, wooden rings. I think they was used for curtains, but I'm not using it for that. I'm gonna use it here. So first what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna add a little bit of tacky glue on that wooden piece and glue it on my book page. Then I'm gonna put quite lots of that hot glue inside of that circle. I'm gonna let the nuts sit down, and if any of that hot glue, I'm gonna a little bit lift it up. If any of that hot glue will kind of leak around. Oh, my camera just sucks. Sorry for that. So if any of that hot glue will leak around, I'm gonna with that not tip of my gun, I'm gonna kind of spread it around because that tip of my hot glue, it's very hot, so it will like iron it all around. And if you feel that you don't have enough, just put there a little bit more of that hot glue and let it dry. Once it's dry, you will need some base painting. I'm using this acrylic from Reeves, black painting. I did paint already these, first with black color, and then I went over it with a bronze color. So I'm gonna show you. Hopefully, it's still hot, but hopefully, I can slowly rip off a little bit that book page. Like this. So this will be my base. And then just paint it first with black or white color of your choice. It depends on what type of colors you wanna have. If you wanna have some gold colors, something very bright, I would go for white color here. If you would like to have this vintage dark look, that a little bit grungy look, go for black first. Putting some beautiful bronze colored or gold colored top coat. You have choices as well. There are acrylic markers with gold or silver or bronze color. There are those beautiful, amazing waxes which will color your product to bronze, color, gold, silver, any kind of tone you want. I'm gonna choose this is Idea Patina bronze color, and I'm gonna choose that. And just very lightly, not gonna take too much of painting on my brush, and very lightly, I'm gonna paint this walnut and that wooden ring underneath. These are dry already, so I'm gonna take two of these walnut buttons or knobs. I'm gonna put quite lots of hot glue here on the bottom and place it right in the middle of my paper rolls. And let it dry. I'm gonna bring here my dry paper and I'm gonna take the bottle. If you feel that you need to wrap something here in this end, maybe it will be good to add their socks and then a small note like for cozy nights or something like that. Then wrap the bottle this way. Make sure make sure you've got these ends together so you know how big piece you need to wrap. So now I remember how big piece I can wrap. And I'm gonna start from this bottom. And if you feel that way, it's good to take help. I've got here this bamboo stick. And I'm gonna just glue that bamboo stick here. Fold my book page over it. And start to roll this paper. Start to roll it, roll it. You can make a roll, but quite big one. Then place your bottle back. I'm gonna flip it this way. Oh no, I can't. Place your bottle back so you can see how far you can go. And roll your paper. It doesn't have to be tight. Sometimes it's better if it's a little bit loose, not too tight at all. And I think I'm gonna end here. I'm gonna put there a little bit of glue and hold it here. Like this. Flip it over so you've got this roll on that side. Take the bottle, place the bottle in the middle of your paper. Try to make sure you've got these sides equal and take one of these circles, place it on one side, take the another one and check where the bottle is the best way to make sure those ends are similar. So I've got it here. I'm gonna keep that bottle here just in case. I'm gonna put a little bit of glue here on that end and glue it to my circle. And then, when I've got the paper glued here, I'm gonna put a little bit of glue here in this fold, just a small amount. And I'm spreading that glue with the tip of my hot glue gun to make sure there will be not big bunch of that glue. Like this. Put your bottle back, take the opposite side, place it here to make sure you will have space there for the bottle and it will be not over the edge. Put hot glue here on that end of your paper and fold it here. And hold it for a few seconds. And again, with hot glue gun, make sure this is straight with your side. And put a little bit of hot glue here to seal it all together. Then roll it a little bit more. And make kind of similar thing like before. Make sure you have here entry big enough for your bottle. Do not glue it that way so you can't put anything inside. I would say maybe it will be good if you will put that bottle inside. And kind of, you know, to guess how far you can go with gluing that paper on this side. So I'm gonna put glue here on that part, I think not far than that, and hold it again. And same, it will be on that opposite side. Hold it till it's dry. Same will be here, make sure it's straight. And I'm gonna put glue here. And I think here it's the far I can go. And then do same like before, put a little bit of glue here in that fold. On both sides to seal it together and make it stronger. Here as well. Do not go too up, too far. So put your bottle inside. Take these small pieces. Put the glue here. Put a little bit of glue inside of this roll and place it on it like this. Try to place it in the middle and press it properly and let it dry. Here it's best when you will wait till it's dry and it will hold. And if you feel that way, you can put a little bit of glue here outside as well. And same way, do that opposite side. And the last thing is decoration. You can use any kind of ribbons, maybe Utah string, rope. I'm going to use this one. This it's piece from our table runner from a few years back, Christmas. It got a little bit ripped off, so I saved that table runner and now I'm using it. You know, I rip it on pieces and I'm using it like a ribbon now. And it has that rough edge, which is brilliant. For sealing, you can use either wax or proper this seal wax. And first, what I would like you to do, it's a good a piece of that ribbon. Place it around. Try to measure. No, both sides. Try to put both ends together. And hold this top part where it's ending on your paper. Place it on your table. And if you're gonna do that sealing with wax, melt your wax. I think it was somewhere here. I forgot. I've got here this stamp with a compass on it. So melt your wax. Then put the wax on that ribbon. And if you don't have those wax stamps, you can maybe use, maybe you do have family ring, or maybe you do have chest with the bottom. If you don't have anything like that, use just top of the glue and put it inside. It will make that beautiful ring and it will look kind of cute. So I'm gonna put there this stamp and let it dry. And once it's dry and nicely done, it's time to place our ribbon or this vintage letter. So wrap the paper around the bottle or the item you've got inside, plus this seal wax kind of a little bit above the edge of your paper, and put there a little bit of hot glue and glue it down here. And then just seal the ribbon all around. Make sure this is nicely wrapped all together. Come here. Seal the ribbon. Just somewhere here. So you will have a chance to wrap it together. Here. Tie the ends. And you have your wrapped bottle done. Maybe put some wishing, some stamp, some label, or your writing, and you have a nicely wrapped bottle of champagne. Or maybe this is big enough, I guess. If you will put there some vegetable, see? 3, 4 cucumbers, and you've got beautifully done wrapping for a vegetarian with cucumbers inside. That will be a beautiful gift, I guess. So this is my sharing for today. I hope you will try it because it's not too hard. I know it's not fast, like quick. It needs some steps, but you will make beautiful and very cute wrapping of any kind of items. So this is my sharing for today. Have a wonderful day. Take care about yourself and see you next time. Bye.